factors promoting economic development. This is not that much important from examination point of view, but we have to know about the factors promoting economic development. If they give, they will give for 5 marks. So first, before going to factors promoting economic development, just I want to recall last topics which I have discussed in last class. Last class I have discussed about factors hindering economic development, means factors which comes in the way of economic development or obstacles of economic development. First point is inadequate resources or lack of resources. Second point is lack of growth of human capital. Third point is lack of infrastructural facilities. Then vicious circle of poverty. This I have explained you in the last class. These are obstacles or factors hindering economic development. I also discussed in last class about the countries in the world are divided into 3 types based on development. So World Bank, according to 2014 report, World Bank has again modified these things, and it has given, I said, so it will be measured in gross GNI per capita income. That is, according to per capita income, world economies are divided into 3 types, mainly lower income, and the second one is divided into 2 types, lower middle income, upper middle income groups, and next economies, and next one is higher economies based on US dollars. That is, first one is low income economies, dollars 1035. Next one is dollars 1000 per capita income ranging from dollars 1035 to 4085. And the next one is dollars 4086 to 12615. And above 12616, we tell it as developed countries. And I also discussed characteristics of developed economies. So what are characteristics of developed economies? First, significance of industrial sector, high capital rate of formation. Third one is high infrastructural facilities, less population. Last one is higher GNI per capita income. Developed countries will have higher GNI per capita income. That is, their purchasing power parity. Purchasing power will be more and standard of living will be more compared to developed, underdeveloped or developing economies. Now next one we see is very important point I discussed is what the characteristics of developing economies with special reference to India. This is very important point. Just I will explain you once, just I will recap once again, okay, with side headings. Okay, first two are characteristics of developing economies with special reference India. First I said low level of income. So we have seen what is this low level of income. We have compared taking 133 countries. Out of 133 countries, per capita income, out of 133 countries, India stands 1/10th position in contributing towards national income or per capita income. So it is 19 countries are far behind than us. So what is the girls? First one is, why this low level of income? Low level of income is because of low level of savings and low consumption. Low consumption because of poverty. Because of poverty and so many, as I said, 1/3 of people, 1/3 of population absence of work, they could not contribute more. This is called low level of income. That is per capita income or contribution. India's contribution towards national income is very, very less compared to developed countries. Second one is predominance of agriculture. I said, okay, 2/3 of population depend in India on agriculture, contributing only 18% to the national income. So much dependence on agriculture. Then what happens? Rainfall is the main source of irrigation. They use rainfall, they depend on rainfall for crops getting produced and all. So there are so many people in the country. Agriculture sector is not using proper technology. That's why level of output, and they are using outdated techniques of production in cultivation, not used for modern techniques. That is predominance. Even though so 2/3 people depend on agriculture, they contribute only 18% towards national income. Whereas developed countries, 2 to 4% depend on agriculture, their contribution is 2 to 6%. This is because lack of irrigation facilities and lack of research and development even in agriculture. Third one is capital deficiency. As I said, developed country contributes 20 to 25% towards capital formation, whereas capital formation is very, very less in India because of less capital, less investment, less investment, less savings, less savings, less consumption. Everything leads to capital. Again, because of lack of capital, we could not use human resources and natural resources in a proper way. We could not use labor, everything in a proper way because of lack of capital. Fourth one is technological backwardness. So India, as I said, we don't have proper technology. Most of the industry and agriculture are not using proper technology. And we don't have, most of the industries and agriculture, we lack research and development. As I said, India contribution towards research and development is only 0.81%. This shows lack of research, and we invest less on research and development, which means that we are not able to use proper technology, modernization, even in agriculture as well as industrial sector. Next one is lack of infrastructural facilities. As I said, what are infrastructural facilities? Infrastructural facilities are telecommunications, transport and everything. So lack of, in India, we don't have proper transport facilities, lack of communication skills, all makes what girls, it will attract for less foreign investment. And most of the industries could not develop in India because of lack of infrastructural facilities. Not only industries, but agriculture also, lack of agriculture also because of low infrastructural facilities. Next one is for more population, high growth rate of population. This is the high growth rate of population is the main cause of poverty. I said developing country like India, the main cause of underdevelopment is lack because high growth of population. As I said, population is increasing every year at the rate of 1.84%. Because of high population, there will be high pressure on agriculture, land and everything, which leads to low productivity. Because of high population, what happens? We could not meet the demand of all the people. How much we are producing, it will not be enough for meeting the needs of our people. So, high level of population leads to high level of poverty, thereby decreasing standard of living. Poor because of lack of nutrition, lack of health facilities, all happens only because of high growth rate of population. Next one is high illiteracy. What is illiteracy? Lack of education. Education, it is high in India, we have high rate of illiteracy. It's from 1951 onwards, even though rate of illiteracy is increasing. But now if we compare male with female illiteracy, male illiteracy is more compared to female literacy. So literate, educated people in male are more compared to female. This shows gender inequality. So again, lack of education leads to all the problems. Lack of education is due to poverty. Again, everything continues. Next one is high infant mortality rate. What is infant mortality rate? I said this. It is infant mortality means children dying at the age of people who are considered as infants. Children who are below age of 1 year are considered as high infant. So infants. So in India, because of lack of nutrition, medical facility, sanitary conditions, we have high infant mortality rate. This they are showing in TV advertisements also. So every 1600 people per day, per 1600 infants are dying per day in India. This shows high infant mortality rate. Next one is traditions bound attitudes towards work. So as I said, in India there are so many castes, sub-castes. What happens? Because of the, we are bonded with so many custom traditions, we do not accept change. We think, so many people think, they accept poverty as fate. They don't want to change their attitude. So this, because of this, it is so because of this customs, traditions, India is still in stage of development. So next one is what? Last one is what? Girls, joint family system. Joint family system. So joint family, how joint family system? Because so many people in the family depends on only one member, head of the family. They will depend on them, he will earn. So what? So many, because so many people depends, low level of income. Income will be less. And then they do not want to shift from one place to another place. Because of joint family, they all want to stay together. They don't want to move from one place to another place. So because this is one of the factors in the name, this is one of the factors, characteristics in India. Okay. First one is low level of income. Easy girls, low level of income, why? Because of predominance of agriculture. Due to predominance of agriculture, capital investment will be less. Because of why capital investment is less? Because because of technological backwardness. Because of this, this is all due to lack of infrastructural facilities. So these 5 points from here. High growth of population leads to illiteracy. Illiteracy leads to high infant mortality rate, and these two are independent characteristics which makes India still developing economy. Even though now India is moving towards path of development, still many industrial sector and agriculture sector, so many people are not enjoying, so many people in India is not enjoying fruits of development because of, as I said, social injustice, inequalities of income and wealth. There is no proper distribution of income, rich becoming richer, poor becoming more poorer. That's why only so some people are enjoying the fruits of development, and most of the people are below poverty line, could not achieve the path of development. Okay, girls. Okay, students. Now I will start with factors promoting economic development. I said this topic you will get for 5 marks. Really, they will ask this topic for 5 marks. So, what are factors which promote? We have seen hindrances, obstacles. Now we'll see what are factors which promote economic development. So first one, they are divided into economic factors, non-economic factors. In the economic factors, so first one is capital formation, or ICOR, means incremental capital output ratio. So first one is, first factor which influences economic development is capital formation. This I have discussed so many times. High level of capital formation. We should have high level of capital formation. Then only when capital formation is more, we will depend less on imports. So then what happens? Capital formation is more means there will be high level of investment. Both industries also should. In developed countries, mainly capital formation will be very, very high. That's why it promotes economic development. By using technology only, we can increase this capital. Industries, by using this capital, they can increase capital, they can increase their output. This is called incremental capital output ratio. As see the, what is this incremental capital output ratio means? Inputs should be less. By using less inputs, we should get more output. This is possible only through modernization and using more technology. If capital formation is less, so what happens? We have to depend on imports. No other way, we have to depend on imports. So we should develop industry, develop industrial sector, capital formation plays major role. So first factor which promote economic development is capital formation. Next one is natural resources. As I said, in India, developing countries have less natural resources. That's why it comes in the way of development. This is natural resources. What are natural resources? First one is land. Second one is water, like rivers and all. Mineral, oils, all comes under, even ecosystem, environment comes under natural resources. We must use, we should use less resources, and we should be able to develop more. The less resources, we have to produce more output using natural, minimum natural resources should be used for economic. Developed countries, what happens is they use more resources, less resources, and they will develop. So in the underdeveloped countries and developing countries like India, natural resources are misutilized, underutilized, non-utilized. They are not utilized properly. properly because of lack of technology and lack of research and development. I said untapped resources. We don't know how to make proper use of resources. That's the second factor which promote economic development is natural resources. Without natural resources, a country could not develop, a country could not produce anything. Even in the industries or agriculture depend on natural resources. Mainly is fertility of soil. Second one is agrarian structure. This place, see, for agrarian means what? The way cultivation methods we are using in agriculture. In developed countries, less people depend on agriculture, but they produce more output because of using modern methods of cultivation. Main thing in India is lack of land ownership. So owner of the land will be one person and tiller of the land will be other person because of inequalities of wealth. There is no proper distribution of land. So that is the main cause in Indian economy why we could not make use of this agriculture. Besides ownership of land, second one is cultivation. How the method of cultivation plays important role. By using modern techniques, we can produce more output. That is which contributes towards economic development. That is called agrarian structure in India. Now there are many land reforms. We are introducing so many land reforms. So methods of cultivation has to be changed in order to achieve economic development. We have to follow modern methods of cultivation. Next one is industrial sector. In developed country, as I said, industries plays major role in economic development, whether it is small scale industries, large scale industries, cottage industries. Research and development and technology should be used more to produce more output from industrial sector. So when we use more technology, we can produce more goods and services, and we can raise capital formation. Next one is conditions of foreign trade. As I said, foreign trade means what? Imported exports, foreign investment. So foreign trade. So we should depend less on imports rather than export. That is main aim of self-reliance. Minimizing imports are the main in developed countries. They have self-reliant even in agriculture, industrial sector, they are self-reliant. They will not depend on imports. So they are self-reliant. But in India, as I said, our third five-year plan only gave scope for this self-reliance. So such foreign trade conditions in foreign trade means we should minimize imports. We should stand on our own legs. And if we are self-sufficient only, we can achieve the path of development. Without self-sufficiency, we could not achieve. Because of lack of infrastructural facilities, technology, developing and underdeveloped countries could not achieve this. This is where foreign trade adds to the growth of economy and economic development, that is self-reliance. Next one is economic system. We have two kinds, capitalistic economy where market dominates whole economic, economic system is capital. There are two types, capitalistic, socialistic. Capitalistic means private ownership dominates market structure, that is called Lacey's way. Less interference of government or no interference of government in market structure. Second one is socialistic economy where government only frames economic policies, rules and regulation. Direct interference of government in a market structure is called social economy, socialistic economy. So to achieve this development, they should either follow capitalistic or socialistic, any one thing to achieve economic development. Our country India is mixed economy, means we follow mixed economy, means both share of both private and public sector in market. That is called, these are economic factors which contributes towards economic development. First one is capital formation. High capital formation, high investment lead to high rate of savings. This can be done by only through ICU war, means input should be less, output should be more. This is possible only through use of technology. Second one is natural resources. We should make best use of natural resources by using technology, both in agricultural as well as industrial sector. Next one is agrarian system, agrarian structure. As I said, land ownership and methods of cultivation plays important role in this, in deciding about this agrarian structure. Industrial sector, industrial R&D should be introduced, research and development technology should be introduced even in industrial sector to produce more goods and services. Conditions of foreign trade means self-reliance, means minimizing imports. Economic system, they have to follow to achieve development, they have to follow either capitalistic or socialistic system. Okay, then we will see non-economic factors. We have seen economic factors, now we will see non-economic factors which contribute for economic development. First one is human resources. Human resources plays very important role in economic development. Human labor as a resource. In India, most of the labors are unskilled. So most of the labors are unskilled. So they could not produce more goods and services. Lack of education. Because of lack of education, they don't know how to make use of resources. Human labor should be, labor should be efficient. Once when labor are efficient, they can produce more goods and services. Labor are less efficient, they are not educated, they don't have proper health facilities. What happens because of all these absence from work? When there is poor health conditions, makes them absence from work. They could not contribute, so output will be decreased when there are poor human resources. Human capital should be efficient. Efficiency means they should be skilled labor having good health conditions. All helps in economic development. But poor health conditions, unskilled labor, not using proper technology decreases efficiency of labor, whereby decreases human resources. Next one is technical know-how and general education. As I said, it is one of the non-economic factor. So people, when they are educated only, when they are properly trained, when they are proficient only, they should know how to use the technology. So when they use more technology, they can produce more goods and services. So lack of technology, know-how, I said as a hindrance for economic development. Using more technology and having good education, professional education, technical education improves economic development. Next one is political freedom. So India and so many other countries are under British rule for so many years. That's why our resources are drained, and the Britishers used our resources and drained our natural resources. Dadabhai Navroji said, in India, poverty is mainly because of political freedom. Most of the years we are under British rule. Because of that, they have used our resources. resources, they end there by decreasing our natural resources, and we could not develop because of the British rule. Mainly political freedom means so many countries are under British rule. They have used our, they have used most of our resources, they have developed, and we became poor. Our natural resources are utilized by, best utilized by them. They have improved their technology, they improved their countries, thereby making our country poor. This is one of the factor. So countries who are not under any other country's rule are more independent, more developed rather than countries which are under rule of other countries. Next one is social organization. So what is social organization? Mass mass participation in development of a country means so many people should contribute for the development of a country. So in India, so many people are below poverty, right? They are not having basic needs. So what they feel? They feel miserable. They could not contribute for economic development. Mostly in India, monopolies and private ownership are dominating, and there is no equal distribution of wealth. Because of that, so many people are under poverty line, and they could not participate in welfare of social organization. They could not participate in social activities. So what is that? Because so many, there are monopolies, private ownership, who are dominating these industries and all. Private ownership all has increased in India. Because of that, so some group of people only, some group of people holding wealth of the country, and they are manipulating, and they are manipulating poor people. That's why there is no participation of all the people in social activities, which is indirectly, which is the factor which promotes economic development. Last one is attitudinal changes. As I said, in India, developing countries, we have so many customs, traditions. We feel that we accept poverty as our fate. We don't want to change. We don't want to come out from vicious circle of poverty. For development, to enjoy fruits of development, there should be attitudinal changes. When we change our attitudes, we can adopt modernization. Our thinking should be very, very positive. Then only we can, if we accept poverty, never we can change. So we should come out of the poverty. We should change attitude, our attitudes toward poverty. Then only we can achieve this economic development. So these are the factors promoting economic development. As I said, economic factors, non-economic factors. With this, we have finished Unit 1. I have covered all the topics in Unit 1. Economic, first one is economic growth and economic development, differences, objectives of economic development. Then next I said indicators of economic development, in factors hindering economic development. Next one is characteristics of developed countries, characteristics of developing economies with special reference to India, and factors promoting economic development. In this lesson, students, you will get mainly three 10 marks questions are very, very important. First one is concept of economic growth and economic development. Second one is what? Indicators of economic development. You will get for 10 marks, and very, very important, which you get for 10 marks, very, very important questions is, what is the characteristics of developing economies with special reference to India? Students, you all listen carefully. If you have any doubts regarding any concept, if you are not clear, just you text it or you approach college, you just we will clarify your doubts. If you have any doubts, you text in WhatsApp like that. We will try to respond. We will try to clarify your doubts. This is the first unit, first concept. You are new to the subject. So first, listen to all the topics twice, thrice. Try to prepare notes. If you have textbooks, we will see. If you have textbook, you just call us. We will give important questions. We will give important points also. So any doubts will be clarified. Don't hesitate to ask doubts. If you have any doubts, you approach either directly to the college or you just text us and we will give response. So just you utilize this. You utilize your stressors. You listen carefully once, twice, as this is very entirely new topic for you. Twice, thrice you listen. Okay, then you try to write running notes. Then also, if any concept is not clear, don't hesitate, girls. We are here to help you. Just utilize this lockdown period. You read, prepare notes. If you have textbooks, we will next class we will discuss and we'll give important points, then you can mark it, you can write, prepare the notes. While coming to the college, you can get it. Okay, girls? Thank you.